Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to add pop-up smart embed code to Google Tag Manager. Before we start, remember this is a one-time requirement, so you won't have to repeat this process again. So I'm on my pop-up smart account. On the left-hand panel you will see the embed code. Let's copy it to clipboard and go to Google Tag Manager. From here, continue with add a new tag. And then you can name your tag. Let's use the initials of pop-up smart. And then continue with tag configuration. Scroll down to custom HTML and then paste your pop-up smart embed code right here. Don't forget to check support document.write. If you don't check this, actually your pop-up smart setup does not work properly. Then continue with triggering. So it's important to note that if you select all pages, our system counts the page views of the whole website regardless of which page you added the pop-up to. If you plan to use your page view limits efficiently, you may choose to show pop-ups on only selected pages and not just anywhere on your website. So in this case, instead of adding the embed code to your whole website, you can edit the specific pages using Google Tag Manager. So to target specific pages, click on the plus icon right here and then trigger configuration, continue with page view, then choose some page views. Then you should choose the event that fires this trigger, let's say page pads, and then contains products, for example, and then let's save it. Note that if you make these configurations instead of all pages, you won't be able to show pop-ups on the pages that weren't specified in the GTM. In that case, you must manually add those pages among the triggers. Okay, once you have configured the triggers, click the save button and then continue with submit. Then we will click publish. You can add a name and description to this action, or you can just skip. So we successfully added pop-up smart embed code to Google Tag Manager. Lastly, if you have an ad blocker on your browser, GTM verification is not going to work, so you need to disable the ad blocker first to verify your website. If you have further questions, feel free to contact us and I'll see you next time.